what I want to present today is what has been doing a little bit lately. This is to improve the styles reviewing and looking into the things itself. So first I want to present what I did for styles and start review. Start review that we have to add some style manager that is common to all style to create style review in one place. Because now we have in the UI other places and when we review the style and every place is using its own codes. So this is my first step. Currently, I just only include it for character and paragraph styles, not for frame styles, which could also have some preview or all these graphic styles, shape styles, for example, Duo. So the first thing what I I use this code for style preview, style formatting sidebar. Now it looks like this. Previously, this was just text. Now this, now the style is instead of text, so we can see the colors, the headings, and it makes a for a beginning user, it's a lot of easier to see what he applies. But one problem here is that experienced users were not really happy with this change, so I had to add the ability to shut it down. Of course, main reason was because of that you can get more styles that can be shown on the window, and they don't use the preview because they know how the styles look by hand. Yeah, so this is now possible to disable currently only for an expert settings, but maybe in future releases this will be also setting of the styles and formatting. Next thing to this is looking into style presets. What is the idea here? Style presets is to apply a whole style, to actually exchange all styles of a document with some template that is defined. It's how currently looks like, and it's design sidebar where you have a style preset and preview which is using also the same preview mechanism that is used for in the sidebar. So what you can do with style presets is you can change all the styles in one document. Something like this is also present in Microsoft Office. How it works is that it just shows the how the styles are in one template file, which is then located in a specific template folder. This is called by convention, I call this style folder. And but and now when you link fresh, you get two styles bundled, style presets bundled, which is quite low. So I hope that people will create more styles that I can include them. There are some issues currently with the current implementation, which is that the undo is month working, so once you apply this time, you can enter work, leave, and generally, screw it, you have to either not save the document, or you can lose all your files. This is just the most main reason that this functionality is still in experimental stage, and the UI still needs working. And that just shows this. Show exactly what I'm doing. These are the start presets that are currently available, and we have some document which has files heading 2, heading 1, heading 2, 3, 4, title, subtitle, these are all different styles. Now if you just double click on before, all the styles are exchanged with the list. What is contained inside this template, and I also created this modern variant. Same principle, but the styles are different. So create your own style preset. Reload again the old document. All you have to do is go file, template, save as template, and this is normal, and this fast folder. You just save and add some name. For example, this one is not saved there. Currently, this is not refreshed, so. Okay, now I'll talk about themes. Themes are introduced in Microsoft Office 2007. The idea is that they implement or said is to create special to take colors and fonts and make them independent from styles itself, so you can better control how to change the colors and fonts independent of the styles itself, which gives you a better way to change the design as simple as possible, and this is pretty important if you want to have consistency. So we have some common set of colors and common set of fonts. You can just change them and all the documents will change the fonts and colors and design changes. But you don't have to go and change every in a style and change every color, so to match it what you really want. For beginning users, this is really nice because they have a lot of color sets available. They just go and select which one they want. Same for fonts. So they have color sets. That's neat. Color set is defined by two foreground colors, text and text two, two background colors, one and two and six accent colors. There are also two colors for visit and non-visit hyperlinks, which are not really solid and useful, but Microsoft Office implements them, so I think we have to look at that too. Yes, now when you have only these colors, this is probably too little colors, so we can add new variants of colors if you are tinting them or shading them, which means if you tint a color, you are mixing it with white, shading the color, if you're mixing it with black. So if you remember how in Microsoft Office, when you go to this color widget, this is exactly this. On the upper row, there are these all possible color variants, and then you have tinted the shaded colors down in the long color columns. And for fonts, there are usually two fonts in a font set, mainly because not really good practice to change the fonts of documents with many different fonts. So they define just one heading font and body font. Heading fonts usually just for the headers, titles, and things like this. Like the body font is for text, normal text body. So now I talk about what are the possibilities, like where we can use this generally for the character paragraph styles and for direct formatting. We can change, for example, font colors, background colors, and border colors, which are usually quite often also defined in styles itself. Then we have shapes. We can use SN colors for peel of the shape, and maybe also create automatic gradient to change a little bit the accent color. For example, to shade it or tint it a little bit and line around the colors. It's also could also be another color. Tables, we can easily do header, you know, table header, which just uses another SN color and alternating colors for other rows. Charts, we can use this, all the texts, the background color. Colors for lines, bars, and points, you can just use all of these colors in a color set, accent, accent 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just alternate these colors. And in presentation, for background, the text color. So I'll talk about what I did so far, and just not really a lot. I'm just doing proof of concept. In a proof of concept phase, we're just so look at how I could implement this generally. So first thing is, I mean, it's possible to read this from OXML, which already has all these attributes. If I would go and implement this for Open Document first, I didn't want to do it, so this was the first step. Second, then I just added just support. You can change the font color in one paragraph or character style, but not all the possibilities that I described previously. I created this new theme deck in a sidebar where you can just change this themes. So this is the themes sidebar, how it looks currently. Which font family or font combination I created some possibilities. And then second was this preview of which color sets are available. Also, we just went out to see what popular palettes I can use. So I just created some Grease Tango and interior blue material with that interior grease from this Android color palette. So now we can actually do this is an XML BookX document. So all styles from this was created in Microsoft Word, and here I just changed a little bit the colors, assigned the color set, the colors to the styles, and now we can, and just load it, and I can just change, for example, currently this created so that we change either both things at the same time. So, for example, we can change for Tutarito fonts and, for example, to Tango color set. And now this should. This should change. I was messing with style screws. So I choose Open Sans and Grease. Now this the colors change and the fonts change. Also fonts now is Open Sans. This is Open Sans family, which is Open Sans. Open Sans font for titles and Open Sans for everything. And we can choose a different one. What it does actually is it just looks up which accent colors are defined and just exchange them inside already defined which are already defined in OXML. But there are also, if we do some different stuff, for example, next steps. So just a little bit brainstorming what needs to be done for to get steam coolers in OAF. Just like this, it should be totally optional. So we put in color just color as it is calculated, and then just add team color information, say okay, this is SM1 color, and what is the tinted shape that it is. And then also similar to the font, and the font, okay, we say this is a team font attribute, and has this usage, for example, body or heading. And of course, we have separated, probably separated file which has the team definition of all of the colors available from in a color set, for example, asset1, asset2, asset3, has this value, this color. And probably all this you have to be then stored inside the zip file where it then shipped together with the document. So yeah, thanks for listening. This is all.
How hard is it to change existing templates to use the new color names and things and so on?
Yeah, this is currently not implemented, but yeah, sure, we have to probably also change the UI, the color picker, so it also supports team colors, and then changing the existing templates would just be to assign a value of the color to the styles and resave the template.
Has that before XML support? Or XML support, like if I say something, but you want to teams, you mentioned something about OVF. Yeah. Can I save such a document to XML and again?
Yeah, you should. I have all the
Yeah, I mean,
the, just what is implemented is just reading, writing back, not what it should be. It should be, I think, one of the easiest tasks.
But when you apply the theme, do you change the templates for heading 1 to heading 8, or do you put hard attributes to the existing text?
I change just styles.
Good, very good.
But it, there are some instances where at least Microsoft Office also allows to change if somebody goes and direct format and assigns a tempo to it. So these instances all have to be changed, not just the styles.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.